There are more than 100 million iPhone users in the United States, and that number might get bigger with Apple introducing its newest iPhone model on Tuesday. Apple rolled out a trio of smartphones at an event in California, the $699 iPhone 11, the $999 iPhone 11 Pro, and the $1,099 iPhone 11 Pro Max. All three devices appear similar to their predecessors, but Apple has upgraded their camera systems to allow for wide-angle photos. They also feature longer battery life and faster performance. The new iPhones are available for pre-order starting Friday. They will start shipping September 20th. Apple also announced a fifth-generation smartwatch and seventh-generation iPad. Joining me now is Starship Capital Managing Partner John Meyer, who is a tech expert. John, welcome to Chasing News. How are you?
Great to be here. Thank you for having me. Doing well.
Seems to me that the phone looks the same. They say they upgraded everything. I feel like every model, they say the battery life is better. What's your take on the new iPhone?
Yeah, it's certainly another one of these incremental improvements. Really getting into the future, you know, Apple's going to have to come up with something a heck of a lot bigger than these year-to-year incremental improvements for the iPhone, because us on the Wall Street side have been seeing for really the last few years now that iPhone sales have been on this steady decline, which is even worse internationally.
Now, do you feel that that's because of the competition with other smartphones, Samsung, etc.?
The sales declining over the last few years for iPhone, they largely come down to two distinct categories of why that's happening. The first is really just the fact that our smartphones have gotten so good nowadays. And so unlike how it was in 2008 or 2009, where the improvements every year were massive, these days, again, they're much more incremental. And so for you to warrant spending $1,000, you know, every year on this thing is very unlikely, considering the lack of big leaps forward.
What do you expect in 2020? What's next? What's the
next 2020
big thing?
2020 is a big year for Apple, and I would predict that in either 2020 or 2021, Apple will finally make a big leap forward with a product that is likely to be in the augmented reality space, which would almost be these sort of glasses that you would wear that would essentially be a computer that you don't have to touch with your hands or your using a keyboard or a touchscreen. Still, it's an uphill battle for Apple at this point, more competition than ever. And they face just the problem of the phones haven't been too good.
I some days miss my StarTAC flip phone.
Likewise.
All right, man. Hey, thanks for joining me. Good to talk to you. Take care, John.
Thank you.